are, it makes the conditions of South Atlantic Coast warmer and conditions at Australia's coast cooler. Pressure systems. This change in the temperature and pressure systems in the Pacific Ocean, where Australia witnesses a high pressure or a very weak low pressure, it is known as El Nino phenomenon. So El Nino is nothing but change in the pressure and temperature conditions, where in the coast of Australia we witness a very weak low pressure or a high pressure. As a result of this El Nino, can I say Australia will have dry conditions? So here we have dry conditions over, and when we have El Nino, this area would see forest fires. So we'll have forest fires in Australia during El Nino. Will we have upwelling in the coast of South America? Now upwelling stops, really upwelling stops. Then the plankton would not come up, anchovies would not come up. Then fishing industry suffers from a loss. What about the migratory birds? The birds would also not come. And as a result, we won't have raw material for the fertilizer industry. Fertilizer industry suffers from a loss. So during El Nino years, we have the areas of Australia which would witness dry conditions, forest fires. South America, mein rainfall takes place, but it leads to the loss in the fertilizer and fishing industry. The alter ego of El Nino is La Nina. Alter ego of El Nino is La Nina. La Nina is a condition wherein the trade winds become very strong. Very strong trade wind means that more water piles up here. That is, more water would pile up along the coast of Australia. Trade winds become very strong during some of the years. When the trade winds become strong, more water piles up. So what would be the pressure here? Australia coast here? A very strong low pressure. So because very warm conditions, you happen. Strong upwelling, so very strong high pressure. As a result, very heavy rainfall in the coast of Australia and very dry conditions along the coast of South America. And we have this condition known as La Nina. So weakening of trade winds, pressure along Australian coast becomes very weak or it changes to high pressure. This is El Nino. Strong trade winds, pressure along Australia's coast becomes strong low pressure, and this is La Nina. La Nina in Australia we will see good amount of rainfall. El Nino in Australia we will see a rainfall deficit. This phenomena of change in the pressure and temperature conditions in these areas of Pacific, it is known as ENSO, El Nino Southern Oscillation. El Nino Southern Oscillation. So El Nino along with La Nina normal condition, this is known as El Nino Southern Oscillation. During some of the years, we have seen that in India we have less of rainfall, and we say that El Nino also influences the rainfall in the Pacific. How does El Nino phenomena, which is there in the Pacific Ocean, would influence the rainfall in the Indian Ocean? Normal conditions. Here what is low pressure? Low pressure would mean that the air would rise up. As the air rises, the air would diverge out. The air rises up, it will diverge up. As the air diverges out, it forms a walker cell and sinks along the coast of South America where we have high pressure. But as the air rises up, divergence would not be only in one direction, but air would diverge out in different directions. So one arm of this upper air diverges, it would move towards the Indian Ocean. So as this air diverges out, it would move towards the Indian Ocean and it sinks at this area where we have massively high pressure. So as this air sinks along the maximum high pressure, what would happen to the intensity of this high pressure? It would increase. So your high pressure tha, iski strength badi thi because of the tropical easterly difference, and its strength is also increased because of the low pressure that we have here. What is the relationship between the low pressure along Australia's coast and high pressure along the coast or along Indian Ocean? Directly related. Stronger low pressure means stronger high pressure. Stronger high pressure means strong monsoon winds, and good amount of rainfall. What happens to this low pressure during the time of El Nino? It weakens or it becomes high pressure. If it becomes high pressure, then will we have this upper air divergence?
No.
If upper air divergence is not there, what would happen to intensity of this? It would decrease. What would happen to strength of monsoon winds? Weak. And as a result, we'll have a rainfall deficit. What happens during La Nina? Very strong low pressure. Very strong low pressure means very strong high pressure. That means strong monsoon winds and more of rain. So if other factors are constant, El Nino results in rainfall deficit. La Nina results in rainfall surplus. But that is related to only southwest monsoon. Though not global, but observations have also been made that during the years of El Nino, we have good rainfall from the northeast monsoon. El Nino ke samay pe southwest monsoon faces a deficit, and we have seen it. Consider the year 2015. In southwest monsoon mein deficit tha 14%, ka rainfall was 86%. 2015 mein hi for northeast monsoon, we had a surplus of 32%, rainfall was 132% of its long term average. 15 was the El Nino year. 15 mein yahan par we had the deficit, northeast mein we had the surplus. Understand the definition. Normal conditions mein kya hai, yahan par high pressure. High pressure is present during the time of summer season. In the winter season, it becomes a low pressure. When it becomes a low pressure, it will start attracting the winds. The northeast monsoon winds will move, and as they will move over the areas of Bay of Bengal, they will pick up the moisture. And as they will pick up the moisture, they will bring rainfall to this part of the country. Yahan tak theek hai samajh aa raha hai? So during the summer season, we have a high pressure. During the winter season, we have a low pressure in this part. Suppose normal conditions, we have a pressure of 100 millibar, and we say that this is the high pressure. We are assuming that 100 millibar is a very high pressure, a strong high pressure. High pressure would lead to winds which are diverging out, and they would bring rainfall. In the winter season, due to changes in temperature, pressure also changes. Yahan par suppose there is a change of 50 millibar, and the pressure now becomes 50 millibar in the winter. And we assume that 50 millibar is a low pressure, and low pressure would attract the monsoon winds. Yahan tak samajh aa raha
hai? Yes,
sir. This is normal condition. What happens during El Nino to this high pressure during summer season? Ki high pressure kya hota hai during El Nino? Indian Ocean. It becomes weak. Let's say it becomes 80 millibar. A weak high pressure, that means weaker monsoon winds, and will have less of rainfall. With the change in the season, with the change in temperature, the pressure will also change. Suppose with the change in temperature, we see the same change of pressure, that is 50 millibar ka change hai. If the change is 50 millibar, yahan par winter mein kitna pressure hoga? 30 millibar. If I compare this pressure and this pressure, which is a stronger low pressure, 30 millibar is stronger low pressure. Stronger low pressure means stronger power to suck up the winds. And as this wind is moving over Bay of Bengal with a strong force, then what would be the moisture holding capacity? Higher moisture holding capacity? Strong monsoons, northeast monsoon winds means yahan par rainfall kya hoga? Heavy rainfall. So during the El Nino years, we have the high pressure which weakens, but the low pressure that strengthens. Ye samajh aa raha hai? So El Nino would result in deficit rainfall in southwest monsoon and surplus rainfall in northwest monsoon. So if a question is there which says El Nino results in rainfall deficit or surplus, the answer is deficit. Because maximum of the rainfall in the country is from southwest monsoon. But the question specifically talks about northeast monsoon, yes, it would result in the surplus of rainfall in the northeast monsoon. So we have El Nino phenomena which influences the monsoon in the subcontinent. Phenomena. Trade winds blowing offshore from South America grab waters which piles up along the Pacific coast of Australia. This is known as the warm western Pacific moon. As if a low pressure develops here, which results in some convection and rainfall. The Pacific coast of South America is a zone of upwelling. Is a zone of upwelling with high pressure. This difference in pressure leads to formation of a cell known as Walker cell. During some years, due to the reasons not clearly understood, trade winds weaken. Warm water from Australia starts moving towards South America. As a result, low pressure along Australia's coast either weakens or changes to high pressure. This phenomena is known as El Nino. Its alter ego is La Nina, alter ego is lying on, which is the result of strong tailwinds. A strong low pressure along the Pacific coast of Australia. Next paragraph. Low pressure off Australia's coast. Low pressure. Of Australia's coast directly influences the high pressure in the Indian Ocean so during the El Nino years. The high pressure in the Indian Ocean is weak. Which results in rainfall deficit. La Nina, on the other hand, leads to rainfall surplus. Within brackets, if other factors are not. Modoki in Japanese means similar but different. Modoki is a similar phenomena in the Central Pacific. Where the temperature of the Central Pacific fluctuates with respect to Eastern and Western Pacific. Most of the older books, if you refer to them, they would write that El Nino follows a 7-year cycle. But now most of the meteorologists, they have a view that it follows a 3-year cycle. And El Nino, if it comes, it can stay for months, it can stay for a year, or it can even stay for a period beyond 1 year. There's 14-15 consecutive El Nino. ocean dipole, or Hindi, or IOD, or Indian E. As a federation, please. Indian Ocean Dipole is an oscillation system wherein the temperature of eastern and western Indian Ocean changes with respect to the long-term averages. Let's say, for example, 1997 was the El Nino year. Because it was an El Nino year, the prediction by IMD was that this year we are going to see a rainfall deficit from the southwest monsoon. But after the monsoon season got over, we found that we had a surplus rainfall. So El Nino year, but despite El Nino year, we had a rainfall surplus in the Indian subcontinent, and that was because of the Indian Ocean Dipole. And since 1999, IMD has been including IOD in its calculations for the southwest monsoon. So it is nothing but it is an oscillation system, where sometimes the western Indian Ocean is warmer than normal, and at the same time, eastern Indian Ocean is cooler. But on the other time, we have the eastern Indian Ocean which becomes warmer than normal, while western Indian Ocean is cooler. Suppose, if you talk about this Indian Ocean dipole or Indian Nino, it has three phases. It has a positive phase, it has a negative phase, and it has a neutral phase. So it would have a positive phase, it would have a negative phase, and it would have a neutral phase. Suppose we have the neutral phase. Neutral phase means the temperatures are same as their long-term averages. Suppose western Indian Ocean where temperature is 20 degrees, eastern Indian Ocean also temperature is 20 degrees. So we have 20 degrees centigrade as the temperature of eastern and western Indian Ocean, and there is no fluctuation in the temperature and no dipole has developed. That is, two poles have not developed. Abhi, during the positive phase of Indian Ocean dipole, what we see is, for the reasons again not understood, the water from the eastern Indian Ocean starts moving towards the western Indian Ocean. As the water from east, warmer water moves towards the western Indian Ocean, western Indian Ocean witnesses an increase in the temperature. When warm water from east moves towards west, that is the positive phase of IOD. And positive phase mein kya hoga? The western Indian Ocean, it has more of warm water, so it has a warmer condition now. Suppose temperature becomes 25. Change is not up to 5 degrees, it is usually 1 degree to maximum 3 degrees, not more than that. So suppose temperature increases. Because warm water from east, it has gone towards west, eastern Indian Ocean becomes cooler. Yahan par suppose temperature becomes 15 degrees. If you have a warmer western Indian Ocean, then what happens is, this is the area where it will have more of convection. More convection takes place, that is more of air would rise up, more of cloud formation, and more of cloud formation would lead to more rainfall in the areas of Indian subcontinent. So positive phase of IOD, we have the warmer water from east that moves towards west, as a result of which western Indian Ocean is warmer than normal, more convection that would result in more rainfall in the Indian subcontinent. At the same time, this is the area, Eastern Indian Ocean, which is now cooler than normal. Because the Eastern Indian Ocean is cooler than normal, then as a result of which Indonesia or some parts of Australia, they would see rainfall deficit. So rainfall would be less in the areas of Indonesia and in some parts of Australia. So if I compare India with Australia, positive IOD, we have increased rainfall in India. Positive IOD, we have rainfall deficit in Australia. Negative IOD condition is opposite, that is during the time of negative IOD, warm water from west moves towards east. As a result, east mid temperature becomes higher, west mid temperature becomes lesser. Now what would happen is that India will see less of convection, will see rainfall deficit. What will happen in Australia, Indonesia? Rainfall surplus. So negative IOD, we have rainfall deficit in India and we have rainfall surplus in Australia. Now compare this with El Nino. El Nino is there in the Pacific Ocean, it is there in the Indian Ocean, that too in the northern part of the Indian Ocean. El Nino, once it comes, it can stay for a month, it can stay for a few months, it can stay for a number of years as well. But Indian Ocean dipole, since the time we have been observing it, we found that it does not stay for a period of more than 6 to 7 months. So 6 to 7 months is time for which it would stay. If I compare El Nino with the positive phase of IOD, what would be the effect of El Nino on southwest monsoon? Rainfall deficit. What would be the effect of El Nino on Australia's climate? Rainfall surplus or deficit? Deficit of rainfall. This is the area where low pressure changes to high pressure, so rainfall deficit is there. So El Nino would result in rainfall surplus, rainfall deficit in India and Australia. But positive IOD, conditions are opposite in India and Australia. Difference kya hai? El Nino largely would impact the eastern part of Australia and IOD would impact this western part of Australia. What if I have a positive phase of IOD along with El Nino? What happens to the southwest monsoon during positive phase of IOD? Positive phase of IOD, in India, what is the rainfall condition? Surplus rainfall, what happens during El Nino? Rainfall deficit. So can I say, if there is positive phase of IOD along with El Nino, it would moderate the effect of El Nino?
Yes.
And it would depend on the intensity of